Hi guys, welcome to Operation Crypto and this price analysis update on Polygon, which is ticker Matic. We'll take a look at it in both USDT and the BTC pairings and identify a few key levels where we could potentially invest and where we can look to take profit. And we'll have a look at it on multiple time frames to see what's going on. If you're new to this channel, please make sure that you are subscribed, hit that like button, and let's crack on. So welcome to the channel. Today we're going to take a look at Matic in multiple time frames and see what's going on in the grand scheme of things. So we'll start off on a weekly time frame and we'll just have a zoom out and see what's going on. Look at that great weekly candle forming. We've used this moving average here over the last couple of weeks, the moving average 20, as an area of support and bounced off it nicely. We've got the all-time highs marked up there, which was up at $2.70. And then we've got the low here when we did that that major retracement down to 61 cents. We've had a good recovery so far, up to the highs with 190% recovery, bounced back, and then we are pushing on. Just looking at the money flow indicator down here, we've been in pretty much positive territory since the 17th of August last year, so it does show that overwhelmingly there's a lot more buys than sales been happening over the course of the last year. Matic, and all things are looking good. So dropping down to the daily time frame, the daily candle looks great, doesn't it? Things are really progressing nicely. I just want to go back in the past and have a look at his latest move and see what we did in terms of a Fib retracement. Yeah, we use that golden ratio. If you ever watch my channel, you probably get bored of me saying it, but I always bang on about this golden retracement. That is a 618 retracement level on the Fibonacci, and we hit that to a T, picked up all liquidity around that. As you can see, it was key area around here as well. And all the way through, it's been pretty much a solid support area. You could drag that all the way through. And you can see that's a fundamentally key level support here. Support which turned into resistance, flipped that support, come back, and then it's used as support again. So that's a fundamentally key level. We just need to be wary. If Bitcoin does get a shakeout, I mean, it's currently progressing well. We've tapped 60K, currently down at 59,400. If for some reason we do get a pullback on Bitcoin, ultimately the BTC, the altcoins will follow it, and you could get some orders down there. So just keep a little bit of powder dry at $1 just in case. But fingers crossed we do not come down to home. So that's a Fibonacci on the higher time frames looking good. Let's just have a zoom in here. We've had a bullish cross forming on the moving averages, which is good. We had that bearish cross on the 20th of September. It brought us down, picked up liquidity, pushed back to the upside. And now we're getting a bullish cross forming on the daily, which is great to see. It's usually a lagging indicator. I mean, you would have been better getting the cross down here. But it does give you a good overall trend directional bias, which way we're going to be pushing. So in terms of buy zones, going to drop right down to 4 hour. And we'll have a look at this latest move. So this was a starter move here at $1.15. Let me top up there at $1.63, but let's have a look at the entire move in terms of Fib levels from the bottom there up to that top. Right, we have rejected off that $1.63 region. If we have a look in, see if it marries it really nice. So we're at that negative 2.7 level is there, so we'll just mark it up as well. Horizontal ray, that's a key level there. But looking at the latest rejection, it was the top end. It just shows that as probably a key area of support. Resistance, should I say. We've got a lot of trading there, fair bit of trading there, and it's very similar to that area there. So 160, 150 is a tough nut to crack. If we're looking for some buys, the first area I would consider buying is here at around $1.45, which would be a very similar position to around there. So that is the area I would consider buys at around 145 to 144. That region could be a nice area to pick up some. If you just look at this in terms of a percentage from current prices to there, like a 3.5-4% drop. So that's an area I would target, and I wouldn't rule out a drop to that golden ratio at 133. So that's two areas. If you're looking for some buys on Polygon and you think, damn, I've missed this pump, those are the two areas I would really consider buying Polygon at those key areas. And like I say, just be wary if Bitcoin does get a nasty shakeout. I mean, let's look at Bitcoin. We've had no major pullbacks yet, have we? And we've not been back to retest this trend line here. So, oh, sorry, that trend line there. So just be wary that there's always that possibility of a 49K pullback. It would be savage, that would. It'd be like a 10% drop. But let's not worry about that so far. Things are looking good and we are currently at around 68k. But going back to Matic, what I want to do is have a look at some key levels above and where we could look to take profit. So that is the first area to take profit, 163, if we push back up there. But then the next major level is that negative 27. So at 176, it's probably an area where I would look to offload some profit. That's either just to take profit in general or use it as an accumulation point. So potentially look at selling 5 to 7% of your bag at that region, and then look to buy back in on that high there at around 163, potentially getting an extra 5% onto your allocated amount. And then looking above, we've got 193, and $2 will be a tough area. If you look at all this trading around here, that's around $2, isn't it? That's probably another key area where we're looking to break through at some stage in the future. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to jump in some further price analysis on Matic over the course of the next few weeks, because we've had a nice bounce back there. I like what the asset's doing. We've got a lot of great partnerships. Actually partnered with Ternoa in terms of NFT bridges, so that's another great asset there too. Currently 20% up on the day as well, which is... it's nice to see. So that's that pretty much covered. What I want to do is just look at Matic in a BTC pairing. Again, we had a great wick up there, but I'm not entirely sure what's going to go on with BTC pairs. I think that BTC is still going to surprise us at some stage and do a big monster candle up. And I would still target some buys at this range here. If you look at this trading period here, I think that could be somewhere we could go down and pick some liquidity up. So if you're looking for buys on Matic in a BTC pair, look at around 1,600 sats. I think that could be probably a decent area if you're looking to load up. It could be a nice area to tap. Cats is going to lower Matt, to be honest. I mean, we've got 900 sats down there. We would have to get a major Bitcoin run to push up. What happens when the Bitcoin itself pushes up? The altcoins in the BTC pairing severely suffer. And that's why I'm identifying these levels below, because they are key areas here. And looking at the overall trend here, been down ever since there, hasn't it? So that's the trend. Currently down, buys down at this range. And I mean, to flip bullish, you really need to attack this area up here. And you would consider that around 3,500 sats. So if you did break above that, that would be a good area to then flip bullish on the BTC pairings. And that's still 50-60% away, yeah. So that's pretty much Matic covered in terms of buy and sell zones in both USDT and the BTC pairings. I would just like to talk about my current Patreon that we have running. So this is fairly new, but we are doing daily updates on this now. We have got a daily update in either a video form or a written form, and then we have lots of educational content. This is, for example, Tuesday's update. Lots of information there about currently what's going on. So we talked about the parachains, talked about what parachains are, and then went to some fundamental analysis and then some basic news. So that is somewhere where you can go. We have a private Discord server, which is here. This is an option with we have trading, Bitcoin charts, chart requests. And very soon, probably next week, we're going to start doing live streams with all members of the Discord community. We've got a Discord bot in there, which pretty much tells you price as you're on your command. And then everything, we've got dedicated news that's getting pushed out once it gets released straight away. So there's a lot for you to take a note of there, but it's something that we are running now at Operation Crypto. And if you want to join that community, you will find that link in the video description and the pinned comment. So that's going to do it for today. If you're new to this channel, please make sure that you are subscribed. Hit that like button, and I'll catch you next time.